Hello dear students, in this lecture we're going to talk about, in this tutorial, very short video, we're going to talk about shortest job first, pre-emptive, right? Okay. So we have here four processes, process number 1, 2, 3, and 4, and we have the arrival time 0, 2, 4, 5, and then the service time or the post time 7, 4, 1, 4. Okay. Very well. Let's draw Gantt chart. Then what happened first? This is the first process that would happen at time 0, P1. The question is, will it take the seven seconds if I assume the seconds? No, it will not take the 7 seconds. So let's assume that we will minus 1 every time and compare. Minus 1 every time and compare. Okay, minus 1 now becomes 6. Is 6 equal to one of these operations, P2, P3, P4? No. Then I minus another one, it will be 5. Is 5 equal to one of these operations? No, it's not equal to. Okay, it's not equal to. Okay, minus another 5. Another one. Then it will be 4. Is 4 equal to one of these operations? Yes, it's equal to this. It's equal to that. Okay, so the processor will stop here. It will not execute this one. Okay. Will not execute it, this one. What I'm saying, it's equal to because I want to see the shortest time. Okay, so what you can see here that we have two processes happened, this one and this one. For this case, or for this reason, P1 will take only 2 seconds. 2 seconds. And then it will compare the last thing, the last time. 5 comparing to 4 and 1 and 4, which is the smallest time here. Okay, when we minus 1 from this 5, there will be 4, right? So 4, okay, will be the smallest time with respect to these two operations, this one and this one. I know that 3 is small too, but this is not what happens in this case. What happens, it just minus 1 and then it's 4. So let's see what the time there that is equal to that. Okay, very well. So we have 4 is equal to 4 and 4 is equal to 4. Which one of these would happen first? When the first time is equal, then at this time we need to look at the arrival time. When the first time or the service time is equal, then we need to look at the arrival time. So we have B2 arrived at 2 and B4 arrived at 5. Which you think would happen first? This would happen first. So write down B2. Okay, write down P2. So we are here. We add P2 now. Would it take the whole 4 seconds? No. Minus 1. It is 3. Okay. Is 3 equal to 1 or 4? No. Then minus 1 again. Now it's 2. Is 2 equal to one of these operations? Is equal to 1 or 4 or 5? Okay. No, it's not. Then minus another 1, it will be here 1. Is 1 equal to one of this operation, 1 or 4 or 5? Yes, it is equal to 1. Then for this reason, we will not execute this operation. We will not execute this operation. We will stop here. So how many operations done? calculate number one. Minus one here, minus one here. So two operations. Then 2 seconds would be here four. Okay? Four. Okay. So when we minus one from here, we will reach to this one, the smallest job in this case. Then we will go to operation number three. We are here now. Operation number three. Operation number three only have 1 second. Then when we minus one, it will be zero. Okay. There is no other values that we can compare to that is equal to zero. It only has one value here, zero. So for this case, we will just write it down, P3, and then we calculate this one, okay? So it will be here, 5. Very well. So the processor will not look at this operation anymore because it's done, it's finished. We still have 4 and 2 and 5. We still have 4 and 2 and 5. Okay. So the operation will go again, make a loop. Okay, which is the shortest time here? Is it 5? Is it 2? Is it 4? Okay, it's 2, the shortest time here. So P2, then minus 1, it will be 1. Is 1 equal to 4 or 5? No. Minus 1 again. It is 0. So finishes. Then P2 is removed. Okay. Very well. Then make another loop. Which is the smallest? 5 or 4? 4. Take 4. Minus 1. 3. Is there any 3? No. Minus 1 again. It is 2 now. Is there any 2 in the process, any 2 seconds, other 2 seconds operation that will be the same? No. Then minus 1, it will be 1. Minus 1, it will be 0. Then this is will be B, okay, B4. How many operations done? Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Okay, and then minus 1, then this is will be 11. Then let's look at the last one. 5, there is no other operations here that we can compare to. This is finished. So this is will be done the last time. Minus 1 will be 4, minus 1 will be 3, minus 1 will be 2, minus 1 will be 1, minus 1 will be 0. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So P1 here will be 16. Okay. Very easy, very simple. I hope that was simple. Okay. So what you can notice here that the operation that takes the largest burst time or the largest service time will always be okay at the end. We'll finish, the finish time will be at the end. Okay, so now let's calculate some stuff. So we have calculated here the operations, and when it finishes, this is the time when it finishes. Okay, very well. So let's put this in table. Let's calculate the finish time. So the finish time is for P1, this is F, which is equal finish time, is equal to finish time here. Finish time for P2 is 4. Finish time for P3 is 5. Finish time for P2 here is 7. Finish time for P4 is 11. Finish time for for P1 here is 16. So if we calculate the turn around time, turnaround time is equal to finish time minus the arrival time. Okay, let's see. So, calculate it for everyone. For example, for P1, turnaround time for P1 equal to the finish time. P1 here. P1, okay, finishes at 16. P1 finishes at 16. This is the finish time. 16 minus arrival time. Arrival time here is 0. So it'll be 16. So turnaround time for P1 will be 16. Finish time minus the arrival time would be 16. Okay. How about for P2? The finish time for P2 is 7. So 7, finish time, minus. The arrival time here is what? It's 2. 7 minus 2 would be, turnaround would be 5. Very well. Let's look at for P3. Turnaround time for P3. Finish time P3, when? At 5. At 5. Here, 5. So P5 minus the start time or the arrival time minus 4. This is the arrival time for B3. And here it will be 1. Okay. Okay, very well. How about P4, the last one? P4 equal to the last time or the finish time is 11 minus the arrival time, 5, would be 6. Okay. This is the turnaround time. What else we want to calculate here? We want to calculate the wait time, the waiting time equal to, waiting time is equal to turnaround time minus the burst time or the service time. So let's calculate it for P1. Turnaround time for P1 is 16 minus and burst time for P1 is 7. 16 minus 7 would be 11. The wait time for P2 is equal to the turnaround time for P2. Turnaround time for P2 is 5. Minus this 5. Okay. Minus the first time for P2. P2. Okay. The arrival time. The waiting time, the turn time minus the service time. Okay. So we have P2 turn time. Turnaround time for P2 is 5, because turnaround time for P2 is finish. P2 finishes at 7, and okay, minus the start or arrival. Okay, would be 5. Very well. So the wait time would be turn around time. Okay, for P2, which is 5, minus the service time, which is 4. Okay, 4. Okay, this will be 1. Just I write too many numbers on the screen, so that's why I just didn't see it well. P3, wait time for P3, the same idea. Turnaround time for P3, which is 1, minus the service time for P3, which is 1. So it will be 0. Wait time for P4, how much this process waited during the other processes. P4, the waiting time for P4 is equal to turnaround time for P4, which is 6, minus the service time for P4, which is here 4. Okay. Here it will be 2. So we calculated the wait time, we calculated the turnaround time. Okay. If you want to calculate the average waiting time, that's very simple. That will be 11 plus 1 plus 0 plus 2 over 4. I hope that was clear and easy. Thank you for watching this video, and hope see you soon.